Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to learn about the modifiers or qualifiers in C programming language. Okay, so it defines the amount of storage allocated to a variable. Okay, and it modifies the properties of a variable. So the amount of memory space to be allocated for a variable is derived by the modifiers. So we are having the four types of modifiers or qualifiers here, that is constant, volatile, size and sign qualifier. So first, coming to the constant qualifier, the constant type qualifier. So here the value of a constant variable can't be changed once it is defined. Okay, so normally the constant value won't change in the execution time, right? So throughout the execution of program, the constant value will be fixed. So here it is given that the value of constant variable can't be changed once it is defined. And once a value is assigned to a constant variable, that value is fixed and cannot be changed throughout the program. Constant space data type space variable name. So this is a simple program denoting type qualifier. So here constant, so we're using the const keyword followed by a data type, that is float, and the variable name we are assigning here is the pi. So we are assigning the pi value as 3.14. suppose we are going to run a program based on the area of circle. Okay, so we have to define the pi value for the area of circle, so that here the pi value won't change throughout the execution of the area of the circle program. So that's why we are going to define it using the const keyword. So this is a simple program here. So main program, so here the function, the main function, the program starts with the main function followed by set of statements here. So constant space int x equals to 10 and int x equals to 5, printf x equals to %d, x. Okay, so %d is a format specifier of the integer value. Okay, so here given two and the variables x. Okay, so the given variable is x. So x equals to 10 and x equals to 5. So what will be the output here? So if the printf statement is executed, what will be the output? X equals to 10 or x equals to 5, the value will be x equals to 10 only, because using the const keyword, so once a value is assigned to the constant variable, that value is fixed and cannot be changed throughout the program. So that's why the output will be printed as 10. Okay, output will be printed as 10 for the given program. Okay, so the compiler is going to neglect the int x equals to 5 value and it is going to give priority to the const keyword. So instead of using the const keyword, so we can define a particular variable and you can see that variable won't change throughout the program by using the hash define function. So here the alternate for const type qualifier is hash define. Okay, so we can define the pi value as 3.14 here using the hash define directive. Okay, so next one is the volatile qualifier. So the volatile qualifier is like a reverse of the constant type qualifier. In the constant type qualifier, the variable won't change throughout the execution of the program, but here in the volatile type qualifier, it is used to create the variables whose values can't be changed in the program explicitly but can be changed by any external device or hardware. Okay, so here it can be changed in the program. Okay, but it can be modified, it can be changed by any device or hardware. Okay, the syntax is a volatile space data type space variable name. Okay, so using the volatile keyword followed by data type and variable name. So here the simple example of volatile qualifier is a system clock. Okay, so system clock will get updated as soon as we connect to the internet and all the subroutines in the operating system are going to execute based on the system clock only, right? So the subroutines will get executed and get interrupted, so all these things will be done based on the सिस्टम क्लॉक, ओके, विच इज़ ए एक्सटर्नल हार्डवेयर. सो नेक्स्ट वन इज द साइज क्वालिफायर. द साइज क्वालिफायर इन सी लैंग्वेज इज यूज टू आल्टर द साइज ऑफ ए प्रिमिटिव डाटा टाइप. सो इट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू टाइप्स, दैट इज अ शॉर्ट एंड लॉन्ग. सो प्रिफिक्स्ड विद द बेसिक डाटा टाइप्स टू एदर इंक्रीमेंट और डिक्रीमेंट द अमाउंट ऑफ स्टोरेज स्पेस अलोकेटेड टू ए वेरिएबल. ओके, सो नॉर्मली द इंटीजर वैल्यू इज ऑफ 2 बाइट्स. सो वी आर गोइंग टू यूज अ साइज क्वालिफायर टू इंक्रीज और डिक्रीज द वैल्यू ऑफ द इंट. ओके, सो हियर गिवन दैट शॉर्ट इज लेस देन और इक्वल्स टू इंट. सो साइज क्वालिफायर इज ऑफ 2 टाइप्स, दैट इज शॉर्ट एंड लॉन्ग. सो शॉर्ट इंट इज लेस देन और इक्वल्स टू इंट, दैट मीन्स सो हियर वी आर यूजिंग द 2 मेन कीवर्ड्स, दैट इज शॉर्ट एंड लॉन्ग. सो इन द केस ऑफ शॉर्ट इट इज गोइंग टू रिड्यूस आर इक्वल टू द, ओके, इट इज गोइंग टू रिड्यूस आर इक्वल्स टू द स्टोरेज ऑफ द स्टोरेज मीन्स इक्वल्स टू द इंटीजर वैल्यू. सो दैट मीन्स इट, सो शॉर्ट लेस देन आर इक्वल्स टू इंट मीन्स लेस देन और सेम अमाउंट ऑफ स्टोरेज एज एन इंट. ओके, सो नेक्स्ट वन इज द लॉन्ग इंट ग्रेटर देन आर इक्वल्स टू, दैट मीन्स सो लॉन्ग इज, so here int should be less or same bytes than a long int. Okay, so here short is going to either reduce or equals to the int, and whereas long is going to, so long will be greater than or equals to the int. Okay, so simply this is about the size qualifier. And the next one is the long double is greater than or equals to double. So long will be always greater than or equals to, whereas the short will be less than or equals to. Okay, so long double is greater than or equals to double, and double is greater than or equals to float. Okay, so double is greater than or equals to float value. So here short means it is going to reduce the int value or it is going to keep it as it is. Suppose if you take the int value as 2 bytes, so int value is 2 bytes, right? So if you are using the short keyword, then it is going to either reduce the bytes. So here it means it will keep it is as it is as 2 bytes. So whereas in the case of the long int, okay, so long int will be greater than or equals to int. That means it is going to increase or keep equals to the int. Suppose we are going to take the long int here, right? So here int value is normally 2 bytes, right? 2 bytes of length, and for the long int is greater than or equals to int. So if you are adding the keyword long for the int, long int, then it is going to increase the size here, amount of storage it is going to increase, so that way it will become 4 bytes. Okay, so long int is 4 bytes. If you observe it in the table of the data types, so you can see the size of the long int is 4 bytes. So that means it has increased the storage capacity. So similarly for long double is greater than or equals to double. Okay, so it will be greater than or equals to double, and double is greater than or equals to float. So this is about the size qualifier. Okay, so it is going to alter the size of a primitive data type. So int, long, short, double, all are the primitive data types. So next one is the sign qualifier. It specifies whether a variable can hold a negative value or not. Okay, it is divided into 2 types, that is signed and unsigned. So in the case of the sign qualifier, it is of 2 types, that is signed or unsigned. So here name itself denotes that signed means the value may be either positive or negative. So that means a particular value is having a sign or negative value, negative sign. But unsigned means, so there is no sign for the particular variable. Okay, that is called as unsigned. Suppose I am taking the, it specifies whether a variable can hold a negative value or not. So it is divided into 2 types, that is signed and unsigned. So in the case of the signed qualifier, so a value will be assigned a sign. But whereas in the case of the unsigned qualifier,
So there is no sign. So that means there is only positive values. But in the case of the signed qualifiers, so we are having both the positive and negative values. Okay. So here there will be both the positive and negative values, like plus 5 and minus 5. But if you take the unsigned values, there will be only positive value, right? It is 5. So if you are taking a value, then default it will become as a positive value, right? So let us know the range of the signed and unsigned values here. Okay, so first of all, for the signed values, so I am taking the value here as, so I want to store number of values as 3 here. So then I can, so to store the 3 bits, so 3 numbers, we need 8 bits. Okay, that is 2 power n, right? That means 2 cube. So we need 8 bits of data to store the 3 values, right? So we need 8 bits of data to store the 3 values. Okay, so if you divide the given 8 bits into two equal parts, then we can know the range of the signed values. Okay, so here, so in the signed there will be both the positive and negative values, right? So that's why, so if you divide the 8 bits into two parts, right, that is minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, and 3. So this is the two parts we have divided it in two parts. So this is the range of the 8 bits. Okay, if you are taking the number of bits to store is 3, then this is the range. Okay, so here, since this is the sign type, so we are having both the positive and negative values. Okay, so if you, based on this one, if you see here minus 4 is the minimum and 3 is the maximum. Okay, so I'm taking the minus 4 to 3, so we can assign the bits here. So minus 4, I'm writing the minus 4 as minus, how to write the minus 4 here? So minus 2 power n. Okay, so 4 is 2 square, right? So 2 power n. Okay, so minus 2 power n minus 1. Because, so here the number of bits is 3, right? N equals to 3. So if you subtract the 3 with 1, we can get the 2 square, that is 4 value. So this is the minimum value. And to obtain the maximum value, that is 3. So we cannot write the n value as it is, right? So that's why, so minus 2 power n minus 1 to 2 power n minus 1. That means 4, right? So 2 power n minus 1 is 4. Minus 1. Okay? So here 2 square minus 1. That is 4 minus 1 is 3. So we can get the minimum and maximum value. So this is the range of the signed values. Okay? Minus 2 power n minus 1 to 2 power n minus 1 minus 1. Range of the unsigned values, so same for the any I'm going to take the unsigned values. So here, so to store 3 values, we need 2 power 3, that is 8 bits we need. Okay, we need 8 bits. So that means, so here in the unsigned value there is no sign, right? So we are going to store only positive values. So that's why, so it will be 0 to 7. 8 bit means starting from 0 to 7. And so here the range will be, the minimum is 0 and maximum is 7. So that's why we are taking the minimum as 0 to, the range is 2 power 7 means, so how to write the 7? So here n is given as 3, right? So 2 cube minus 1. So that means 7 only, right? So 2 cube means 8 minus 1 is 7. So this is the range of the unsigned values. Okay, and we can find the range of the different primitive data types by using these formulas of the range and range of unsigned and signed values. So this is about the different modifiers in the C language. And thanks for watching my video. Thank you.